that they use on their dessert pizzas and get the cinnamon on the fucking cutter, and then they cut your pizza and you're eating your pizza and it's like, I'm tasting cinnamon right now. Why, who has defiled the pizza? Hashtag first world problems. All right.
There is cinnamon on my takeout pizza that somebody made for me.
Damn it. Fuck. They
and
should be using
that
separate
pizza was
cutters.
Too big to fit through the door.
That was funny. The pizza that was too big to fit through
the
door.
The big slice was the best. The best pizza story is the big slice in downtown Toronto, where the little dude who showed up to deliver the pizza over his head, because that was the only way to carry it through the hallway, couldn't get through the door, and we had to like...
Oh, so gluttonous.
And we were all like, how is this only $15?
It's the magic of fast food. All right. Rotted zombies. I don't think we're done. So that was the reaction.
About to get his ass beat.
That was the reaction as he saved Krieger from getting grabbed by the zombies, and then they all start pushing in.
Did we kill the zombie?
Oh yeah, you smoked him. You smoked him.
No, I mean on screen, did we kill it?
Yeah, you killed the one that was grabbing Krieger.
Okay.
All right. So a few of them had to move, but the three down to the bottom. I think there are three on you that didn't have to move.
I believe you.
Okay.
All right.
They're going after the guy with the glowing sword.
Who's spouting them out of existence?
23, 9, and 14.
23 hits. 23
hits.
Oh. We'll save the 9 and a 14 for a moment. First, I'm going to do damage. 5. 5 damage is the thing claws at you. I believe when something has grab, it just spends an action.
Oh, God.
And grabs you.
We are spare parts now, bud.
Ah, nuts.
Well, that makes him flat-footed.
Yeah,
so.
I'm gonna mark this one, even though it doesn't have to, like it's not considered grappling. I'm letting you know which one is grabbing you, because the others are just doing a feeding frenzy on you. AC 9 flat footed and AC 14 flat footed still doesn't hit.
No.
Okay, then we've got two that are at 1d20 plus twos, 12 and natural 1. And then we've got two of them that have moved in, so they only get a single attack this round. AC 13, AC 21.
Nope.
21
flat-footed. Yes.
Flat-footed.
21 hits.
Okay. Their teeth, as this one is, because you're grabbed, it actually comes in and is starting to bite at your flesh, and you get bit for 4 damage.
Okay.
Fuck. Marking your character.
And then one stumbled over the body of the one that you destroyed that was grabbing at Krieger and is trying to grab at Krieger for AC 24.
Yep.
And gets hit for 4 damage, but it doesn't have any other actions, so it can't. It can't grab at creature. Krieger, it just claws at your knee.
How you doing down there?
For how much damage?
For 4.
4 damage, right.
Oscar.
So, let me know when you need a hand. I'm going to stab this. Oscar's going to step over and stab the ooze.
Okay, the big twirling ooze that's trying to get at Bone Crusher. Another pseudopod is growing. You stab at the pseudopod.
AC 14, AC 19.
Hits twice. You're getting it, says Ptolemy.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm doing a good job, and I'm really consumed with stabbing this ooze. 16 damage.
Okay, not quite half of it's been scraped off the ceiling. Ptolemy is going to help Oscar with a fiery bolt. hitting the ooze for 2d4 plus 4 as his produce flame burns it a little bit. About half the ooze, it has now been scraped off. The guy who opened up the trapped room, you don't know what he's doing now.
Oh, we're
better
so...
be taking off his pants. Just don't take that the wrong way, though.
Leave him the shadow. That's all I'm saying. I have a hard time seeing later.
So move, manipulate, manipulate. Okay. Alkur.
Alkur sees the wounded zombie.
Yep, the one that's clawing at Bone Crusher.
The one clawing at Bone Crusher, and he's going to fire a Divine Lance at it.
Okay.
Don't worry, Crusher, I will finish it off. Phew! Just off to the moon.
No, actually, because you're kind of like like sinking down low. You actually hit the rim of the top of the ceiling, like right in front of Ptolemy. Oh, did you mean to do that?
No.
He's very impressive, says Ptolemy. I like magic, Darian.
I do too. He'll cast a shield spell.
Darian, you're being grabbed, bud.
Darian's going to attack the grabber.
Okay.
AC 24.
Yeah, the zombie's grabbing you, but it just presents a very nice target as you ram your glowing longsword right through him.
Is that a critical?
It is a critical hit.
All right.
And somebody's moving Krieger.
That's Mark.
I'm
not moving anybody right now. I'm typing in on Twitch.
You are in the middle of a Krieger movement.
Once he finishes his roll and goes back to the map tools, right, he'll catch up with the...
All right, so the first attack does 40 damage.
Okay, that's double the hit points that the zombie has. It is ripped into pieces.
I don't know
pieces.
How that happened.
Wow. Plus 28.
That was a critical. Yeah, it's I got.
Oh, you crit. Yeah. Good God.
It also.
Oh no. Sorry.
10 less.
10 less.
It still destroys it. You're no longer grabbed.
Oh, we accidentally added the weakness twice.
Yeah.
All right.
Next attack.
Who are you attacking?
Let's see. One of the one that's. We're going to attack zombie 10 here.
Okay.
Just to get rid of that.
Pulling your sword out of one zombie and hacking over your shoulder to the other. To the other side.
AC 22.
Critical hit.
Alright. Can we just call it dead?
It has 20 hit points, so it's possible for you to roll less.
Yeah, I guess it is.
No, it'll be 22 minimum.
Oh, right. It's crit.
Yeah.
Okay. It's destroyed. This time, the sword cuts its head off.
And
it's kind of chomping as it goes down to the ground and then stops moving.
It'll attack zombie 7 on the last attack.
Okay, then kind of a short slice with the glowing longsword.
Misses, I think, with a 9.
AC 12, you don't have a plus 3 on that last one?
Nope.
Okay. Most was at plus 0 when it last.
All right, this one it got in too close. Like you expected an opponent to kind of stay away from you, but it's actually shuffling in really close, so you end up elbowing it and not getting your full swing down. Krieger, your turn.
Okay. Krieger is going to attack the one right next to him.
Oh yes.
Critical
That's
hit.
20.
Leave me a 20, goddammit. I know it's not supposed to work that way, but we know it does.
We know that's not how dice work, but...
I know, but it does.
Splitting the thing in half from shoulder to groin, the whole zombie just rips apart.
Yeah, I'm just over here cleaning my dagger. Don't mind me.
Playing with the weird tentacles that are coming down from the ceiling.
He'll take a step or hop down the stairs and attack that guy.
Oh, this place is filthy and now strewn with rotting zombie carcasses.
19
hits it. Normal hit. A sideways swing with the axe.
20 damage.
Does exactly enough to kill it. You carve off the top 3 inches of its skull, revealing its brain, but it's enough of a brain hemorrhage to cause the zombie to flop and fall down. Bone Crusher.
Two quick questions. Am I in my mountain stance?
You are in mountain stance.
You're in mountain stance. You've been punching this one. It's got 1 hit point left.
Okay, so second question. Do arrows do damage to zombies?
We haven't checked yet.
Sorry, Shadow hasn't attacked one yet.
He has not attacked one yet.
He's been attacking the sewer oozes coming down from the ceiling.
I think this one has like 1 hit point.
Yeah, no, this. Yeah, all right. Okay.
Just FYI, do what you like.
No, I barely hit.
Okay, you kick the zombie in the sternum.
11 damage, it's gone.
Your foot goes into the zombie's chest, but hitting its spinal column, and it crumples down. Its head trying to bite you as it goes down, and you end up pulling your foot back really quickly.
No problemo. Let's take out the one in front of me.
All right, hammering your foot down.
Now, when I flurry, do I have to flurry the same character?
Let me check, but if it's like the ranger one is yes. Let me check.
The ranger one's yes. Yeah, I'm thinking.
The monk one might not be yes.
Flurry.
I bet you it's the same one.
Mm-mm. Don't say two attacks at normal penalty combined.
No, it's
damage.
If both.
Sorry.
You can flurry two different people. You just don't get to do the weakness.
Add the weakness. Yeah.
Yep. So yeah, okay. You can flurry.
So d20 plus six. Miss.
AC 10, zombie is
faster than that.
It absorbs the punch.
Hey, one hit.
However, when it gets in really close, you just decide that headbutting it will be good.
And another miss. Okay, so be 1d8 plus that. 6 damage.
6 damage, you headbutt the zombie and it still comes after you.
Yay.
Sewer ooze. Well, Oscar's attacking it, so it's trying to undulate towards Oscar. A pseudopod comes flying out towards Oscar's face.
Yeah, I thought you were going after that one. Oh.
AC 11.
No, no, no.
Okay, it twirls around, AC 8.
No, no, no.
And AC 1. Okay, so Oscar's just backs away from
there. We go. Oh, they're just gonna
Shadow.
Quick question: have you guys been subtracting arrows or kept track of how many arrows were shot?
About 20 arrows were shot.
20 arrows. Okay. So that makes that
no.
7. Nope. I just took it as that. No, that's
five. Five full round attacks.
Five full round is 15 arrows. Wait.
20.
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, yeah, okay, that's good. Cool, thank you. I know what I have left. Okay, so Shadow's gonna aim at that zombie in front of Crusher.
Okay, just turning from the sewer oozes, he decides to help his brother.
I was attacking sewer oozes?
Drakester's saying something interesting in chat.
Dude, Oscar is that one evil dwarf god from Legends that was stealing shit in heaven, right?
Yep.
Dwarf god.
He was described as there was a entity that was in like a scene. That's a concept. Now whether or not that is cohesive or could just been another guy named Oscar.
I may have used the token.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go have to look check the tapes on that one.
Drake, you would have to remember what episode that was, would you?
And if you answer too quickly, we will be scared.
Altagar failed to trip it.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Because I remember. Remember he was brought out.
Legends feels like so long ago.
Because it was, man. It was like 2 years ago.
I wasn't 40 yet.
quick question. Yep. Was I already attacking oozes?
No, there was one ooze on your right hand side. That's fine. You can help your brother.
Is it considered an animal?
Nope.
It's not.
Nope.
Okay.
It is considered a ooze.
Is anything a prey here or not?
Nope.
Your prey was killed last round.
Okay, so ooze is my prey. And then 1d20 plus 9 plus 11. Crit?
Crit. They can't be critted. They're immune to crits.
Oh, good. Just the one fuck time! 1d8 plus... Oh, Shadow. I think it's a 2 that you...
Oh, have. You're getting up to some really good episodes, Drake. The 70s were really good episodes.
The 70s? You realize what you just said, right? The 70s were great.
9 damage. About 3/4 of the ooze has been destroyed.
Okay, let's continue that. Plus... Let's see. 11, 3, 8. That's 8.
Nat 1 is a miss.
And it begins. Okay, there's a 9 plus 6. There we go.
That last one hits the ooze for 5,
five damage.
There's still some of the ooze that is combative.
So, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Yep, that's it.
Rotted zombies! Bone Crusher, you got the attention of the one that you punched.
Yep.
It's making noises as it's trying to claw at you. AC 21.
That is my AC.
I will react.
Okay. It does 6 damage.
So take 1.
I love you, sir. And I mean it.
Okay, so Darien kind of bumps the zombie as it's trying to grab. It
bumps him. Fucking cut his head off.
Well, yeah, you bump him with your shield, and then it kind of opens up his underbelly, and you stick your blade into his body, and then just cut down.
Yeah, it's
critical
it's
hit.
Crit.
Okay,
it's critical hit.
So Crusher was gonna get grabbed, but instead, the zombie slayer Darien. This is pretty funny right here that Darien killed 3/4 of the zombies.
The five-faced god is not impressed.
Well, there's one zombie that's still clawing at Darien. AC 11 and AC 5 misses. Oscar, you're next.
I'll show you how to fight news. Oscar's willing to clean his blade. AC 23.
Hits. You do more than 4 damage?
Yeah.
Okay, so that first hit, you cleave through a big tendril that seems to be keeping the mass of it affixed to the ceiling, and then it glops down to the ground and stops reacting to your motion.
We'll try to kill steel. well, as far as I can't quite get the flank. We'll stop there. Why is the mouse behaving strangely? All right. And we will... stab at that zombie, AC 15.
Okay, Oscar comes whipping down the stairs, hitting the zombie in the head. Sticking the rapier through its eye.
Probably should use the dagger. 6 damage.
Okay.
Doesn't stab good.
Yeah, it didn't mind having a rapier stabbed into its face.
Cut the flesh, cut the bone! No, crush the bone.
Ptolemy is going to use the height of the stairs to send a produce fire, a fiery little bolt down towards it. AC 25 is a critical hit. So 4d4 plus 8 fire damage.
Poof. And I believe that's persistent.
The zombie ate the firebolt, and its head is on fire, and it's stumbling around, and then falls down. It just adds to the horrible stench of this place. He ends up killing it. I lit that one on fire like a taper.
You did.
Excellent.
I'm getting the hang of this. All of you stand in front of me while I kill things.
Is that really what you just saw?
Well, actually, I saw my squire's blade ripple with some strange energy that I'm not sure I like the look of.
Uh-huh.
It was a magnificent display. Darien?
Yes, Darien's one of the best. I trained with him.
Truly blessed by the five faces.
I am fortunate to be so. Now we've got a little turd hiding in a cave that needs to be brought out into the light.
let's press forward.
Okay, there are some wooden doors to the side. They're dirty. They've been clawed at. There is a much sturdier door that looks like it's been repaired. And then all these metal doors were opened. Oscar, you can definitely see some of the workings of the trap. This was a large iron gate that also opened up.
And then
just to give you an idea, like, there are zombie bodies and slime everywhere. I'll put all some of the zombies back. There's this huge pile of corpses all around you.
Do you ever think on what kind of vessel we could use to gloop up the slime? Oscar's gonna go take the door.
That is a lot of bodies.
I'm assuming the zombies weren't wearing anything of...
No, it looked like some of their funerary clothes or perhaps under armor was still clinging to their putrefied flesh.
You're picturing it too, the t-shirts and the...
are you looking? Are you spending time looking through the zombies?
No, we're gonna collect ourselves up a turd first.
Okay. Oscar looks at the door. The door doesn't look like it's locked, but it does look like it is barred.
Hey, Crusher, this door requires your expertise.
Finally.
Expertise.
yeah, boss. 2d8s. Number 60, part 4.
Thanks, Drake.
Thanks, man. I'm scared.
I'm going to make note of that.
Officially.
Just in case Marty misses it.
Yeah, please
awesome.
Make note of
that. Thanks, Drake. That's wicked.
It's in the notes section of Ostrich's character sheet.
Marty, you just want me to do damage to the door?
Yeah. No, we kind of established that given a few rounds of work, like a minute of work, most masonry is destroyed. Oscar steps away while Bone Crusher goes and makes short work of the door.
Yep.
Okay, you pound this door open, basically ruining the door. It reveals a small chamber where there is another door. Inside this chamber, there's a mess of filth and broken junk. There is a... like a wooden iron reinforced door that leads into the next chamber. It looks like they might have sorted loot here and kind of left behind like the shelves of barrels and of broken open boxes, garbage, burnt ends of torches.
We'll sift through you.
Door two.
Is anyone else when you get to the second door, Bone Crusher, you actually hear some stone moving kind of further in the next room, kind of like...
Oh, start getting to work! So I think I can hit the door four times in a round.
Blam!
Yeah, four times around.
Alright, revealing a chamber that is held aloft by some support columns. These columns are heavy in stone and seem to be driven deep into the earth. You, from the litter here and the big matted matted bed of straw, strewn bones, and a collection of like helmets and buckets for water or worse type of water, you get the sense that the ogre might have treated this room like a like his lair. There's a heap of old clothing mixed in with the straw mat. There is a large wooden chest. It looks like somebody long ago took an axe to the front of the wooden chest, ruining the lock. I'll put the wooden chest on the map.
So Crusher steps through.
There's a box, and then there's a like a big matted flea infested bed on the ground.
Crusher step through. There's bounding.
This door is a metal door. There is a rusty key stuck in the metal door on this side of the lock. And there are some ropes and things that are in coils at your feet.
Survival?
Maybe then I'll try to have a look at that first.
Sorry, there's a key in the door?
Yep.
Oscar.
Can we track the movements of our friend Chuckles? Chuckles McBusted Leg? We don't have a name for him. We don't know what his name is.
Yeah.
I think Chuckles is the, what
okay,
it is
so
now.
Bone Crusher's checking out doors. Oscar, what are you doing? You're surveying the room for stuff?
I'm not touching that door.
I am looking for... I am trying to follow the tracks of the man whose legs I need to break.
Got it.
So I am using a survival.
Yep.
Ten.
Too much dirt and grime in this room to really make sense of anything.
Okay, so...
You keep on seeing ogre tracks in it.
Stop wasting time. Where'd he go?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. This place smells of booby traps.
Oh, this place smells of one type of wrong to another, says Ptolemy.
Shadow does his survival. 21?
Ignoring the ogre traffic, there is a considerable amount of foot traffic that kind of goes along this far wall.
This way.
Almost like they avoid the filth of the ogre. You're not too sure why it goes along this wall.
Great.
Well, is there a door on the east side?
Yeah, that's what Shadow's looking for.
You don't see a door.
Oscar, take a look over here. There's got to be something here.
Oscar, we'll take a look at this. Look for traps on that south door.
It's sure. On here, right?
Yeah, it leads... The filthy tracks lead all the way up to this wall. Yep.
There's something through here, I think.
Okay, I'll inspect the door in front of Crusher, and then I'll inspect that corner.
Get your dumbass over here, Crusher.
Okay. First, the door in front of Crusher? Sure. Oscar takes a peek underneath the crack of the door. You look at the door. At first you thought it was like a little like doggy hole, but actually it's to put in feeding trays or to pass things underneath.
It's like a prison cell?
It's a prison cell.
Okay.
Whoever here was lazy enough to just have left the key in the door.
Okay.
All right. That looks like a cell of some sort. He probably gets you in there. Oscar will knock on it a couple times, like dook, dook, dook.
Okay.
Crusher starts pounding the wall.
So, Crusher's just taking the approach of, I'm going to start mining through the dungeon. All right. So Oscar opens the door. Yeah, there is a prison cell. There are multiple like chain links up against the wall. A lot of mildew, a horrible looking crack that is probably used for excrement.
What quality of chain are we talking?
No, I'm talking about like the chain, like the loops that you put chains.
Oh, okay.
Quality of loops.
We'll say that you find an old, rusty, shoddy pair of manacles, the type that a blacksmith has to bend into place.
Perfect to put around somebody's leg. Broken.
It's a splint. Quit whining.
All right, so Oscar is looting while Crusher is mining. Yep. Oscar, you do see that there is some long, like, woman's hair and a bit of a torn dress.
Gonna take the dress because we already know the weavers, so we might know who made the dress.
Yep.
What colors? So it's in the loot pile right now. It's not really loot. It's more clue.
Clue.
Torn dress / bit of hair. What color?
The hair is blonde, and the torn frill is from a serving maid's outfit.
Uh-oh. Hey, look what I found. Are you two wusses still in the other room? Get over here.
There's lice. I can see there's lice again in that, the bugs in that bedding.
Well, I'm not asking you to go into bedding. Come in here in the cell with me.
No.
I think this might be from the missing lady.
Oh, that's unfortunate she wasn't here. Or fortunate if she was not here. The ogre seemed very temperamental.
Shadow steps in. How long ago has it been here? How long ago was it? What's here?
Yeah, how long ago is this place occupied? Sure, you start sniffing at the hole and checking for signs of...
26.
A lot of different people have spent short periods of time here. Like on the order
short period of time.
On the order of like days to a week.
They don't spend much time. They're here and they're moved.
Yeah.
Hey, do you want me to go figure out where the door is, or are we just gonna let him?
Well, Bone Crusher eventually is sticking his fist through something, and there is a small chamber that he reveals in mining. There is
this way, quick.
There is a, so let me mark where the holes are in the chamber. So you kind of mind your way through a door. Oops. Did I draw that on the token layer? That's annoying. You mind your way through this door and you actually see another door. These are more like stone doors meant to be concealed, and you've completely destroyed that one.
Oscar, I think it'll be faster if you just open it.
Do you have to break everything? I mean, like, actually,
don't
everything.
Open a fucking door.
How am I going to reuse this place if you keep busting everything?
Okay.
I have to bring workers in.
Crusher and Oscar hear the sounds of, like some sort of metallic contraption going clank, 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 and then there's a boom, like something fell into place and it's deeper within.
That would be, yeah.
If you're setting more traps over there, it's gonna get worse.
You'll never get through this.
I don't think you understand.
I have a challenge.
The power of the burning greed of revenge.
What, you fucking prick.
All right, so Oscar, this is not meant to to stop you in any way, you find a latch and the door opens, revealing stairs that lead up a little bit. A hallway that ends with a small elbow. Or actually bends with an elbow. And then you actually can see, you can hear the man laughing. There is a wooden and metal portcullis that has fallen, and he's standing behind it.
You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here, and you killed our fellows. I'll give you one chance to scurry away. Leave your
corner.
Yeah, leave your treasures right before this portcullis and leave.
You gotta be fucking shitting me. I know how this conversation goes. You might as well take off your pants now.
He sees the archer. He starts backing away.
I'm muted.
Okay, well, when Oscar approaches, he starts, like, backing away. It looks like he's gonna go around a corner.
Oh, does Shadow see him?
Yeah, Shadow sees him.
Prey.
Okay, you set him as prey, and then he kind of goes running around the corner.
You bastards!
You can still hear him, though.
Leave your things behind, and I won't tell on you.
Crusher.
Not a few. Out of my way.
Pushes him back.
Stand backwards, safe, Shadow.
That's right, Crusher.
It is safe back here.
You're the meat.
He was the one with that heavy flail, right?
So big heavy flail.
Yeah, he's got it on his back. He's peeking around the corner.
Ew, orc. Stay back from the portcullis, or I shall summon a swarm of enemies that will tear you apart.
You know what I hate? Hey. I hate people who pronounce portcullis.
Marty, Shadow's going to sneak behind Crusher and try to take a shot at him.
Okay, so you're going to sneak up and try to like... You're aiming through the little...
13 stealth.
Okay. Yeah, he...
I see you there. You're uglier than the other one. You're not supposed to be here.
Is there any light here?
Although if you throw down your weapons, perhaps, and ask nicely, I could arrange an interview with Lareth the Beautiful. We are hiring new thugs. Especially given that you... Well... made an opening for yourself. Quite violent. We have a need for violent men. Would you like
you
me
are
to
not
make
on the side of civilization, coward? What is your name?
What are you doing?
Oh, can we? Oh, Shadow Crusher's already pounding against it.
Oh, Crusher has moved up to the portcullis. Okay, I just realized I don't have the portcullis drawn.
We were working with conceptual portcullis.
It was
the portcullis of the mind.
There.
Sorry, it was a trap. Like, he could have brought it down in your heads, which also would have been funny. So, Bone Crusher is walking up to the portcullis.
Get back! Get back!
You know,
Shadow's gonna give him cover. He's gonna stand over here in the corner. And just keep an arrow like,
I got a question for you.
You could ready a rapid shot.
Ooh, let's do that. When I see him walk around. All
right, well, you can see, like there's a bit of light around the corner. There's not much light down this way. There are a lot of tracks, Shadow. There are a lot of tracks. Humanoid tracks, you're having a hard time, although you're not paying attention to it. Is Crusher now punching, or are you waiting?
Crusher looks back. Everyone's waiting.
Yep.
What are you doing? They're getting through!
Okay, so at this point in time, it's how many people can he alert while you're trying to punch your way through?
Bring all the warriors.
Bam!
Bring it on, asshole! Let's just make a small opening.
Bring on exactly 250 XP per party member to this hallway.
All right, I'm going to add Ald to the initiative. I'm also going to add Bugbear Warriors and Gnoll Bandits.
Ooh, no bandits do some damage.
Kill this guy.
This is hilarious. He's just running through the dungeon alerting everything.
Well, he's our guy. He's like our mischievous guide through the dungeon. Basically, he's telling us which direction to go. It makes exploring so much easier. It also makes us bumble through traps. Also, we will get to say, well, I follow his footsteps so I don't fall through the pit trap or whatever.
The asshole with the mace.
He's gotta know that his life ends in a very painful way. Whether in our hands or he's gonna eventually fall the wrong trap or something. Like, it's gonna. Darian will be like sleeping in one day and be like, what happened to him?
I don't know. I woke up and half my arrows are in his face.
He fell on 30 forks. What can I say?
He suddenly, tragically, horrifically slipped while eating and stabbed himself with 30
accidentally,
forks.
Accidentally, maliciously, he died. Spare parts, what can I say?
Spare parts there, bud.
He clearly broke every bone in his own body.
Alright, we got some bugbear thugs.
Mr. Glass over here.
And some gnoll hunters.
I'm assuming they are hunters of humans.
Wouldn't be a bad assumption. Although they could be just hunters of butterflies.
Favorite enemy butterfly. Why would you take favorite enemy animal?
Over here, monarch. I shall wear your wings.
Good times.
If you're ever in the Singapore airport, they have a beautiful butterfly exhibit. They also have a carnivorous plant exhibit. Also interesting.
Cool.
Mm. Things of nightmares, really. Plants that move and kill things.
Yeah, those are awesome.
Yeah. When you look at the mechanism that goes, yes, this can kill a mouse. Like a full-size, big kind of mouse.
All right, Alcur, what are you doing?
Oh.
You get the sense that Bone Crusher's cracking his knuckles, he's like, okay, I'm trying to get through! The games are afoot.
I have a feeling that it might be a good time to bust out the bless.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah, it's a good idea now.
Good time to bust out the bless.
How long does it last?
A minute.
Okay, and then it spreads, right?
Right, so he will move forward and bless.
Shadow.
Readying a flurry. Not a flurry, a rapid shot.
Okay. Gnoll hunters don't know anything is going on yet. Ptolemy is just going to move up and crap a hide. Are we fighting in this cramped hallway?
I'm hoping not.
Well, we got to get through the cage first, don't we?
Is it time to pull out the big spells?
No.
I'll save mine. Bone Crusher.
Punch you.
Okay, I need to check to see. Basically, you've encountered like the front door of a castle. So let's see what hit points this thing has.
Monks must be in high demand. An army. So they don't have a barricade. They don't not a barricade. A ram. They have like 5 monks.
All them going
speedbagging the wall.
The monks are furious.
It's why they only have like rice paper walls. It's because there's no point.
There's no point.
No point.
easily replaced. That cost a dollar.
If you've ever been a very large man in a building with those sorts of things, I was so self-conscious of, like, don't stick my hand through the wall, don't stick my hand through the wall, don't stick my hand through the wall.
That would be the best place to rampage, though.
Like, don't lean against anything, don't touch anything.
Can you guys find, like, doors and barriers? And I'm not sure where the... I previously
had look up damaging objects
earmarked, but I can't seem to find it. Go ahead and roll damage on it. It is your full round attack.
It's the DR.
We'll tell you once we figure out the...
Right. 2d8. Well, yeah. I'll roll all of it and subtract DR 3 times.
Don't do that. Just in case the DR is more than 4.
Yeah. 2d8 plus 8. Balls. I roll balls. 1d8 plus 4.
Thunder.
And 1d8 plus 4.
Remember 4.
Okay. Creatures, factions, religion, playing the game. Damage.
Sundering?
Well, I'm checking athletics now to see if Sunder is...
There's a whole section of...
577 is... Where you're gonna find the
materials, hardness, and
materials. Yeah.
Dommage les objets.
Oh, here we go. Yeah. There's a table on 577. A reinforced door is hardness 10. 40 hit points, with broken threshold of half of 40. An iron structure, like an iron plated wall, is hardness 18.
Yeah, okay. So this is hardness 10, 40 hit points.
Okay, so how many rounds have I had?
One.
Working on the door? It was just one round?
Yeah, you started the initiative this
round. Okay, hardness 10. Okay, so I do...
So it's 2d8 minus 2 on the first attack.
2d8 minus...
Which you rolled, so that's...
Yeah, so three...
Three damage?
No, sorry. For one damage, and then on my last hit, six damage. Minus four.
Two damage.
Two damage.
So, three damage so far.
Only three damage so far.
Okay, so, the way through. So you're rattling the thing, and you splintered one of the cross beams in one section of the
portcullis. Now, I can do better.
Yep. All right.
He's trying to get through. That's it. That's it. I was going to keep your treasures for myself, but I suppose I could share it with the tribes.
Bugbears don't know anything.
Help! Help! You dirty nose! Help!
He went left?
Yeah, he was down this way. You can he's yelling and you can hear things waking. Darien.
Oh, Darien's gonna make his way around the corner. Just standing there waiting.
Okay, Oscar.
Well, does he see him? This thing would require like a lot of muscle to lift.
Yep.
Want to lift it, or we want to smash it?
There reaches a point that if he breaks it, lifting it might be difficult because it won't fit into the groove in the ceiling.
Yeah. Well, I suppose once they bring enough reinforcements, they're just gonna open it up themselves, won't they?
That would be my guess. Yeah.
I wish I saved my illusion.
All right, Krieger.
Krieger's just—he'll hang back there for now.
Oscar grabbed cover actively.
Okay. Alcur.
We'll push the bless out that he might have popped early.
Okay, the gnolls are now all rousing and grabbing their stuff and probably doing a little bit of a move forward. Yeah, you can hear them.
Help! Help, Intruders! Intruders!
Tommy?
Oh, I can't wait to kill him.
Killing him is going to be awesome.
Tommy? Ptolemy is just gonna move up, cast a shield spell. Bone Crusher.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Oh.
Three damage. Okay.
One D4 minus six. 1D8 minus six. Nope. 1D8 minus 6.
Krieger with the magic
one damage. Krieger could probably do a lot of damage on this thing.
Okay, you are breaking it, but it's slow going.
Krieger will get in there.
Yeah, and guys run it. You can hear some goblinish being spoken, perhaps down this hallway. Like it's however coming from deep throated creatures.
Rage, I guess.
You dirty flea-bitten bugbears! The gnolls are gonna get all the treasure!
I speak goblin.
What's going on? Who's that? I don't know.
Darian?
He's waiting.
You know that guy's friends are all dead, Oscar's gonna say in Goblin? You should probably just kill him and take his treasure. I hear he's got a magic flail.
Fuck you, it's not magical! It will be after I pick through your corpses!
Nah, I'm pretty sure it's magic. You should smash his skull and take it.
Nuh-uh!
Or maybe just break his legs, just in case. It'll be safer that way.
Intruders!
Darian
is still just waiting.
Okay. Oscar?
Oscar's gonna keep on messing with the guy.
Krieger?
Krieger moves up there and wails on the...
On the portcullis where Crusher's trying to bend and break a...
Yeah.
Damage.
Yeah, if I got a rage, that takes an action too, so it's only one attack for this round. But it is 17 points of damage.
Okay, so 14 damage.
That's what I'm talking about.
The thing, there are some splintered cross beams and.
No, I think it's 17 after DR.
Oh.
Yeah. That's 17 yeah. After.
Maybe you should.
24. Okay, now there's enough broken pieces that you doubt the thing would fit neatly into the ceiling. Like you've broken that section. There are two sections that are exposed to you, so you're basically trying to make a 5-foot wide hole in that northern section. Alcur.
he'll push his bless out another 5 feet.
Okay. Shadow.
Cast a shield spell.
Readying action. Readying the... You know, rapid.
All right. Let's move that here and see what the movement rate of these guys are. 24 feet, 50 feet, 75 feet.
Oh, hello there. Would you mind killing the intruders? They slew the ogre.
What language is this?
He's speaking in common. They're chattering amongst themselves, I think, in Gnollish, but...
Do we have a sledge? We need a sledge.
A sledgehammer?
Sturge aside! We will take care of them.
Oh, yes, do so before the bugbears get here. You know how they like stealing your treasure?
Bugbears will not steal our treasure. We keep what we kill.
Oh, I'm going to tear this guy's tattoos right off.
If you kill that guy, you can probably keep his flail.
They're close. They're on the other side. Ready your bows.
Whoever breaks his legs gets his flail.
Ptolemy, oh, they've got bows. And he hunkers down the stairs and is taking cover, raises his shield. Bone Crusher.
Let's try to do something here. 2d8 plus 8. 5 damage.
5 damage? Yeah. Okay, you guys are getting close to making that opening a thing.
Nope. And nope.
Okay, you are opening up castle-worthy barriers with your bare hands. It's still quite impressive. Bugbear thugs.
Stupid gnolls. They always take our treasure. We're going to take it from them. The rules are we keep what we kill, but we also have to give sacrifice.
That's all in Goblin. And...
Bust through it, Krieger. Go.
Sounds like they're trying to get through.
Shadow and the others with with dark vision get the sense that there's something very close to this corner. Like they're just about there. Yeah, there's a lot of meat come this way.
You're so fucked now. There's no way you're going to kill all the gnolls and the bugbears. Don't say I didn't warn you.
Do me a favor and don't crap your pants.
I did pee a little, and my pants are brown.
Just tear the skin off his face.
Darian.
Waiting.
Okay. Oscar.
Like, readying your shield, grabbing cover?
Yeah.
Oscar's going to, like, weapons drawn, going to grab cover.
Okay. Yeah, Darian can grab cover basically behind the portcullis that isn't being torn down. Oscar can grab cover around the corner. Krieger.
Krieger is, well, we'll see how many rounds it takes. So 10 damage after DR.
It's got one hit point left. There's still some jagged, like, you try to pass through there, you're going to get cut. There's some jagged metal bits that are still there.
So he hits it one more time.
Okay, there is a 5-foot opening in the portcullis.
And then
let me...
So we just as a time check.
Rage! Yeah.
Check with Mark, just because he's...
Yeah, it's 1:30.
Oh, I don't work tomorrow.
Oh, cool. Alright, caffeine!
We're defined!
Yeah, it's 10:25 here.
We're good till 2.
Got it. Awesome.
Krieger runs around the corner, sees a guy, and he's got that wild, crazy rager look in his eyes, like.
Okay, well, Krieger sees more than that. Does Krieger have light? Actually, the dude has a lantern.
He's got dark vision.
Okay,
he's got dark vision.
All right. Well Krieger sees and hears a mass of things around the corner.
Oh, that's a lot of dudes.
Yipping and hollering. They've got bows drawn. And then you also caught a glimpse as you ran by, maybe a shaggy-looking, hulking goblinoid creature with big ears.
Uh-oh. How does one accurately convey fear whilst in a rage?
Just sort of like eyes wide. Yeah, exactly. Alkur. I think we did this. We got it. We got it.
I think we're through. Do we want to be through? Alkur will spend an action to push his bless out yet again.
Also, don't know if this is too many gnolls and bugbears or not. Don't know. This is lazy DMing or dramatic DMing.
We might use the gate as a funnel.
Alkur is going to move up to the gate and take cover behind the gate.
Okay. Shadow.
Can Shadow see anything?
No, you can hear movement.
Okay.
And then Krieger's definitely reacted.
Shadow's going to move up to here.
Okay, you move through the breach. That black part, I can move
25 feet.
There's something satisfying about the word breach.
I think
it's better than opening. Feet. We have a breach now.
Yeah, you know, you've breached their defenses. I believe when castles are breached, it means intruders are in the castle.
And then I ready a good rapid word. Shot.
Move and ready. Yep.
Move and ready, yep.
Gnoll hunters. Well, they all kind of come around. And they've got short bows, so I think they're okay with taking a single move up and just pincushioning Krieger.
That seems unfortunate. Unfortunate.
I think one of them will finish Krieger off with his battle axe if it comes to it.
That's a lot of... That's
all right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 at plus 10s.
No, it's fine. Oh. I was looking at Druid anyway. They're pretty good, so...
18, 25, 27, 23, 26, 24, and 27.
21 or higher.
No crits, but lots of hits.
Do you have any DR or anything like that?
Nope.
I believe they're just D6 each.
Yep. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 66 damage from the gnolls. That's 23 damage on Krieger.
Ow.
What is that movie where the samurai is running around with all the arrows stuck out of them?
Throne of Blood.
Throne of Blood.
Marty, there was Shadow had readied. Do I get to shoot that gnoll that came into view?
This is the gnoll with the battle axe. He has cover from this corner, but yes, you could try to shoot the gnoll with your readied action.
Okay, good. I'm not in the bless, right?
The bless has extended. You are in the bless. This one gnoll kind of comes through after all the archers attack.
Are they considered animals?
They are not animals. They are humanoid gnolls.
Mother.
All right. So 9, 10, 11. Okay.
Your rapid shot with cover. Yep. This guy has AC 20.
Damn.
Hits the wall. Hits the wall. He yelps. Osha, you're next. Two hand his battle axe into Krieg. AC 12 missing. You deflect with your own axe. He had to move an attack, and he's got a second attack at plus 5. For AC 16, also missing. All right, Ptolemy. I think needs to get up there to help. I think the helpening needs to happen.
Yeah.
Krieger needs fucking healing.
He's going to move up and take cover. No, move.
I used my heal nukes.
No, he's gonna move up and use his focus point to cast... tentacular limbs. I'm sorry, I have to do it. His limbs turn into these black rubbery octopus tentacles. He's apologizing to Darien.
Yeah, it's fine right now, actually.
Okay, I don't want to disappoint my squire. He's actually a really good squire. if you don't mind me saying, and he winces like the words, your next words could cut deep.
Yeah, just tentacle things right
now. Okay. Bone Crusher.
This is bad.
All the while, Durian. Ald is laughing.
Okay.
We can all just kamikaze it, Ald.
Crusher gets to... Okay, so that was... Yeah, it's one move. Is that a... Am I in a wall?
You're squeezing there.
Okay, I want to do Medicus on him.
Okay.
I did Darien. I did not do Krieger today. So, Crusher's Medicals. Come on, laptop. There you go, buddy. Medical is that. Hey, it succeeds. Adam, 2d8.
2d8.
Fuck. 4. All right. Better than nothing.
All right.
Pulled one arrow out.
Sitting inside your neck. Can I try to hit this guy?
Yeah, I'm going to be nice and say that's not a squeeze when you're standing there. Yeah, you can hit this gnoll with the bow in his hands.
All right. So Flurry on the 20. What is your Flurry, Mr. Crusher? 10. We're not in the Bless, are we?
I think we're out of it.
I think Crusher's too far.
6.
Okay, they seem reluctant. They seem to they skitter back away from your grabs. It looks like they want to back up a little bit. Actually, they're fine with pin cushioning. They look a little cowardly, like they're taking bolstered their morale through numbers. Bugbears, however, start shuffling around the corner. They move at 25.
You might want to get the fuck back.
Yeah, maybe.
Krieger, we need to retreat.
Can't let the gnolls win. We must get more sacrifices than them for the temple.
They're saying this in Goblin.
They
seem
not planning to do nothing nice to you, Krieger. Might want to get back.
Okay, that was one move.
Oh no.
Ooh. At least they don't have reach.
Get the archer!
And they are going to
bum rush.
Two of them go running at Shadow.
Yep.
The other ones in behind see Crusher and Krieger, and they're going to shoot javelins. So two bugbears run past Bone Crusher as they're trying to like get ahead of the gnolls, and they don't like archers. They are swinging bastard swords.
They are bastard.
AC 22.
Hits.
An AC critical hit against Shadow.
Those are against Shadow.
Oh.
My armor is 20.
So okay. Hit and critical hit.
The first attack is... they're two-handing these suckers, so 1d12 plus 4 is 12 damage.
Okay.
And the critical hit is 2d12 plus 8 is 18 damage.
So it's 30 damage. Shadow's up. He's not happy, but he's up.
Oh, we got this one. The weak ones are hiding behind.
I'm not weak, says Ptolemy in Goblin.
Oh, that one speaks Goblin.
Old. He moves back.
If we survive this, we're gonna have to. How do we do atonement in this system? There could be one.
Darian.
Darian's gonna put a shield up.
Yep. And enters the breach.
But no, we're leaving. Fuck out.
He's gonna.
Let me see if the bugbears have reactions.
No, he's just moving there. He can't get there fast enough. And he's going to attack the bugbear, I guess.
The bugbear thugs do not have reactions.
I'm glad to hear that.
All right, so you're attacking the thug?
Yeah. AC 15.
AC 15 does not cut through the bugbear's natural hide and his leather armor.
It's almost 2 a.m. and we have hero points.
That's a good point.
You don't get to keep them. Might as well use them.
Sure. Unless you want to save your hero point
for burpees.
For burpees, yep.
Do the hero points still do burpees?
I think it might require two. I'm not sure.
I don't have two, so I'll just use the one I got.
Okay. You're re-rolling your attack roll?
Yep. Same one. All right. Well, that is what fate decides.
Yeah.
Oscar.
Oh, you gotta be fucking shitting me.
I know, right?
Yep.
It's so dirty in here.
We should retreat and use that bottleneck as tactical advantage.
We're gonna double move and stab this bugbear.
Okay,
in the way.
He is flat-footed. AC 15.
AC 24.
Chicken parm. Yes.
Are you in the bless? Because that would be a critical hit if you bless.
I am in the bless, and I include it in my roll.
Okay.
8 damage.
8 damage. Okay.
Is that with a flank?
There's a flank in there.
Shadow is threatening because you have unarmed.
Yep.
Proficiency, and that includes the d6 for. Okay. The bugbear grunts underneath the from that attack. The bugbears look tough, Krieger.
Krieger's gonna
move back. Maybe the gnolls will fight with the gnolls.
Pull back to here. Attack the bugbear.
Okay, Krieger limps back, covered in arrows.
Not good.
You don't look good.
AC 18.
Hits the bugbear.
What? 14 damage.
Okay, bloodies a bugbear.
And then
that one's pretty hurt.
Pull back some more.
That's awesome.
You're like, oh, whack!
Yeah, Magnus the shit out of this man. We don't have any magical healing left.
Alkur.
Alkur is going to fear Bugbear 3.
Okay. You've got the range for that?
I believe so.
I assume it's a will save?
30 feet, it is a will save.
He rolls a 24 total on his will save.
He is frightened 1.
Okay, F1 on that bugbear. Shadow.
And we'll extend the bless out a little bit further.
So it's like hitting Crusher now?
Yep.
Okay.
Shadow's going to step back to Hela.
Okay. Moving back through the breach from whence you came.
Okay. Mark, that's 1. And then I'm going to mark him as my... Yeah, I gotta start marking these guys as my prey.
Have fun, Drake.
Heading out. Take it easy, buddy.
We'll be back on Saturday. Because I
hope we survive.
They've got the rest of this dungeon to go through.
Fuck.
there's an army of fucking bandits down here.
So move back,
Mark.
You know, you're only supposed to bring us 250 XP per character worth of stuff to this hallway.
Marty, they're not considered animals either, right?
We're,
the bugbears?
We're power leveling this mega, this mini mega dungeon.
10, 11, 12.
We're going to show up to Barter Town or whatever the hell it's called and basically be like, nah, it's ours now. All right, Lord Mayor, kiss my ass.
Nulb? Yeah, yeah. Chicken parm, baby. Chicken parm. I'm having chicken parm tomorrow. I'm going to go out for a beer with Levi and have a chicken parm. That's the plan.
10, 11, 12. Okay, so 12, 13 on the guy that's close to me.
Chicken parm with almond flour is, like,
pretty... Wow, does that hit? I would love to roll more than a d4.
The bugbears have AC 17, so no. That hits the leather armor.
I roll a plus 13 and I miss.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, you flurried. That's a hit.
20. There we go. Alright,
the triple move combat is so fun. It is fun.
It's very dynamic.
Five
damage, bringing it to him to 27. He's still standing. He's in single digit hit points. Bugbears are tough. That's why there are slightly less of them than gnolls.
Hopefully they really don't like each other. Maybe they have a fight down in the hallway there.
Gnoll hunters. Well, the one with the axe isn't moving in yet. Crusher, you've got cover around that corner. What's your AC as you're getting a lot of arrows put towards you?
So Crusher's AC is 21.
You add one for the cover if you don't take action with it.
So 22 then.
Okay, these two are not. Actually, that one's with the axe. So that one moved, so he's going to fire twice. Oh, yeah. That. So the first one is AC 18, the second one is AC 21.
Is it full cover or is it lesser cover?
Lesser cover.
Okay, one AC.
So my AC is 22 right now.
Okay, so this one missed twice after moving around the corner. This one didn't have cover against you because he moved. Okay. So does the AC 21 hit?
No.
Okay.
Oh, wait, he doesn't have cover?
Yeah, you don't have cover against him.
I don't have cover.
Because he moved, 21 hits, yeah. He moved around the corner. Okay, so you 21
hits.
You get an arrow that grazes your knee for 2. Okay. Now, all the other gnolls you have cover from, and this is probably proper cover, so you have AC of 2. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
23. Okay.
I don't know if that guy in the back has line of sight.
1, 2, 3 hits.
There he goes. Okay, cool.
Okay.
One's a crit.
1, 2, and then one crit. So 2 hits.
Yeah. So 4.
46. Is 11 damage, and then the crit, short bows have deadly, so they add d10.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Is it the deadly 11. D10? Holy shit.
And the crit does 10. So 21 on Crusher total. Now the one with the axe steps forward.
There should be another d6 in there.
Yes. For the crit.
So,
4.
10,
so another 4.
14.
25 10, damage. The one with the axe, 36. 5 foot steps up and takes 2 swings. AC 23, no cover.
Yep.
And AC 7.
Nope.
Okay, 9 damage.
Okay.
He's still up?
I think so.
I'm saving my reaction for a bugbear attack, because I'm more fearful of that, I think.
I'm checking Crusher hit points. 47! You're still up! You're still good to go!
Wow.
Everyone than 0 is good to go.
You're still good to go.
All right, tell me. I'm just going to look up Chill Touch because I think his tentacles can reach.
Yeah.
I think he can use an action to extend the tentacles and then use his chill touch to automatically touch that one bugbear that's really injured. I don't know if it'll do enough, but we'll see. Focus spells. Tentacular surprise. No? It's not a focus spell? Oh, under sorcerer. Okay.
It spent all your hero points to remove the dead or dying condition.
All hero points, not two?
No, it's now all.
Okay.
So if you have one, that's enough.
If you have one, that's enough. And then we haven't actually done the death and dying rules in this, so.
Okay, so his reach is 20. He would have done that when he cast the spell by spending an extra action, which is fine, which means he didn't take cover. And then chill touch is an automatic hit.
I think so.
That some does, of them are. That does 1d4 plus 4 damage with a simple fort save.
Okay, fort save from Enimer.
He makes it.
So he takes half.
So he takes 2. And he's still up. Bone Crusher.
Get out of
here. Okay.
You guys gotta be shitting me. Is Oscar's out next to get Bone Crusher?
I've been saying, let's get the fuck out of here.
Well, you see, the thing is, we broke the gate, so and then the door is broken too. So there's really no way for us to sort of separate ourselves from our foes, because we sort of smashed everything on the way.
There's a door that's still open. It's still closed.
Yeah. This door is open and closable.
As the bottleneck occurs, they just start fighting each other.
So, Crusher's gonna, he's gonna flurry one knoll and get the fuck out of there. Hold on, can I reach a...
The one with the axe?
No, it's whoever, yeah, the guy's closer to me.
Yeah, Fox, we have to do this like it's rogue. I think that elbow by the stairs is the perfect spot because the archers can't get line of sight.
Seven.
You can't be line of sight without line of beat.
What's their AC?
The gnolls?
Yeah.
Gnolls have AC 18.
Yay, 2 hits.
Okay, so you punch the gnoll with the axe a couple of times.
20 damage.
20 damage, he's bloodied.
Oh, this is a problem.
Oh, shit.
Wham!
Oh, wow. Balls.
There's a lot of hit points and holes in this hallway.
There's more hit points than we have fuel for. He's like, ooh, we still up. Good luck. One.
He took that. Oh, shit.
Yep. Ooh.
Orcs away.
Crusher goes limping back, all injured with arrows sticking out of you.
Less than 5 hit points each.
Wow. All
right. Yeah. The injured bugbear is going to take a single swing at Darien and then probably move back as well, because he's like really injured as well. So they're pretty smart foes. A bit dim, but good wisdom. All right. So yeah, he's going to take a single swing at Darien with his bastard sword wielded in 2 hands. Swing, clang, AC 15, and then this injured bugbear is going to lope back with the others. And probably just take cover back here. This one waits. These bugbears are going to make a pincushion out of Oscar as they pull out javelins.
What do you mean?
And they whip their javelins towards Oscar.
So move, throw.
AC 12, natural 20, AC 10, AC 25.
The crit is a crit, and the hit is a hit.
Okay.
One hit, one crit.
Javelins do 1d6 plus 4, so 2d6 plus 8 with a javelin. 17 damage.
Oh. Run away!
Okay.
And then the second javelin does 5.
All right, Oscar is...
So these guys were there.
He's
they
like, fuck you, dude.
They pull out a javelin and throw it.
So it's an action left.
They draw their bastard swords.
Okay.
This one hasn't acted yet. He's going to swing at Oscar with his bastard sword. AC 15.
No.
Nat 20.
Well, that's a problem.
Okay, I'm going to use my reaction on this one. Well, he does damage. It's nothing there.
25 damage.
Okay, so you take 20.
I'm unconscious either way.
Okay.
You're unconscious?
Yeah. And that I'm dying too, because that was from a crit.
Oh. Darian's going to move in and do his retributive strike on it.
Okay. So you blocked it a little bit.
I think I'm dying too. Let me get the death and dying stuff.
Yeah, we're going to have to... Let me know what page that's on.
The death and dying. Detecting delay demon. Am I spelling bad? Yes, I am. 459. Okay.
Mace's balls.
Okay, recovery checks. Taking damage while dying. Getting knocked out and dying. Creatures. Reduces 0 hit points. Begin dying one. If the effect that knocked you out was a critical success, you get dying condition two. Okay, now. Recovery checks. When you're dying at the start of each turn, DC equals 10 plus your current dying value.
It's a flat check.
It's a flat check, so you just roll a dice. Okay. Dying always includes a value. If the value ever reaches dying 4, you die. Okay. Alright. Unconscious dying, so I'm at 0 hit points, because there's no such thing as negative, and I am dying 2.
So how do we get you out of the dying?
I cast Stabilize on him.
Anytime you lose the dying condition, you gain the Wounded 1 condition or increase your wounded value by 1 if you already have the, I think, wounded...
This gets rid of the burpees.
Yep.
Because your wounded doesn't go away.
Until you treat take wounds.
A long rest or have a surgery.
Yeah. 10 minutes. Until you're pushed to full hit points or rest for 10 minutes. Interesting. Yeah, that increases your max dying value before you die. Alright, so this bugbear downed Oscar. He's not going to continue to attack Oscar. You stepped in, Darian, to block some of the damage, which still was enough, however. And then he has his secondary attack?
That was his secondary attack.
Okay.
Second attack. He's got a third if you want.
He does have a third.
This one's mine,
is what he says. And then he's going to push past Darian to here. His frightened one goes away.
Yeah, the frightened one made him have a minus on all of his rolls.
Yeah, he should have had minus one, but he rolled a nat 20. Okay, Old. He stops laughing and checks up on the situation, and he's going to scoot. Excuse me. Oh, you're having a hard time, are you?
Hey, you fucking prick.
My snarky guy is down, so.
Yep. Darian.
All right. Lay on hands on the dwarf.
Okay.
Pick him up.
How much hit points do you heal?
Oh, I heal 12.
Okay, so Oscar's at 12 hit points and now just prone.
And
then I pick him up.
And wounded one.
Wounded one, yep. Okay, how many actions was
two actions.
Lay on hands is one or two?
One action.
Okay, picking him up, you could use an action to write Oscar up, like pick him up by the scruff and put him on his feet.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I can't drag him, eh?
I think you can.
Okay, I. Pull him. Yeah. Well, yeah, I guess that's as far as we're going.
Okay, you pull him into a flank with Krieger. You kind of like, get over here, and you're sort of pulling him up as you're going and pulling him down the hallway. All the bugbears are waving their swords and telling the gnolls to stay back.
Are my weapons back there?
I think when you are unconscious, you fall prone and drop items you are wielding or holding, unless the effect says otherwise. So yes, your weapons are back there.
Ah.
That's okay. Fine. I will kidney punch the shit out of this guy.
Oscar.
I will kidney punch the shit out of this guy.
Ah! he's stopping your escape.
For fuck's sake. Sorry, that's an AC 12. That's an AC 18.
AC 18 hits.
He is flanked. Mm-hmm. Another AC 18.
Two hits.
Punching is D3 or is it D4?
D4. I think it's D4.
So
plus your sneak.
2D4 plus
dex.
8 plus 2D6. 20 non-lethal damage.
20 non-lethal bloodies him. Non-lethally. On that second punch. Krieger.
Krieger's gonna fucking end this guy.
You know who's not attacking non-lethally? AC 22, yeah, the axe. Blah! The retributive great axe comes hammering down on the bugbear.
Miss. And AC 19. Two hits.
The 22 might actually kill him, so I don't know if you want to hold off on your actions.
We'll do it to him separately then.
Yeah.
Don't want to grab cover.
23 damage?
23 on top of the 20 non-lethal knocks him out.
Good enough.
I'll just give him that state.
I guess he's... That's one attack. He'll ready in case any more bugbears try to come through.
Okay. Alcur.
Or enemies.
Alcur is going to 5 foot step forward. He's going to use a medicus a treat wounds action on Oscar.
Okay.
One away from a critical. For 12 healing.
No. Oh, no. Never mind. Never mind. I'm not doing that. Go ahead. Sorry.
Okay. So that was a move and a heal.
Yep. And we're going to cast a shield spell.
Things are bad.
God. Oscar's butthole. Oscar's butthole.
Should be on the inside.
Shadow.
Arch okay. Back, you bastard.
Yeah, so these guys have arrows. These guys, the bugbears have swords now?
This one has an axe out. The other ones have bows out, but you only can tell that from the number of arrows that are in Krieger and Crusher.
Yeah,
they're yipping and hollering. So,
whoever has a ranged weapon is gonna get some arrows.
Okay, this provides cover, this barrier. Okay. These guys have all these guys have taken out their bastard swords, and they're yelling at each other. You are right; they are in competition, but it doesn't look like they're at the point where they're gonna come to blows over.
Okay.
Of course, the one that said, this one's mine. Of course, Oscar's back up now, and he's down, so... I think fair is fair, and... The dwarfs...
Okay, this guy is injured.
Yep.
The gnoll with the axe has got 20 damage.
Yep.
Okay, he's bloodied. Let's make him our prey.
Okay.
And kill one of them. Let's drop their morale down.
Okay, he has cover because you're kind of firing through the arrow slits.
Yeah, so what's my... What's the AC, you've got it.
Yeah, the AC
okay.
increases.
This is your thing.
To 20.
Okay, so pray. I'm in the zone of bless.
Yep.
Yes. That's 13. All right, good.
Hit. Shadow kind of sees the creature through one of the squares.
Nope.
But the porculus, that one hits the side.
11. No, that's supposed to be one less, actually. 13 is supposed to be a 10, and then a 7. 24.
Two hits.
So 2d8 plus 4. 9 damage.
9 damage on top of the 20. My gnolls have 29 hit points. You've dropped a gnoll.
Jesus Christ!
We can't trade blows with this number of enemies.
Know. The gnoll hunters.
Don't know how to not trade blows.
If you're too chicken to go down there, we'll put arrows in them.
And oh, a bunch of gnolls come running around the corner with their bows out.
I was hoping that would discourage them.
Can they all do that in a single move, or was that a double move?
That was a single move each.
Fuck. Well, at least one of them can't see us.
Yep. He's going to have to double move over the corpse, which is very unlucky. Three. That one can single move there. Okay, so we've got... Darian and Oscar seem to be the guys to target. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So these top four are going to go against Darian, and these back guys are going to go against Oscar.
I'm so... don't know how I became the front line.
Shit.
Don't worry. They want captives.
They'll heal you.
Oscar could be a good chaotic evil worshiper of right. doom.
Darian, four arrows, primary attacks against Darian. AC 13, 15, a dirty 20, and 15.
None of them hit.
And how about no?
That's a hard no.
That's a hard no.
And then their second arrows, dirty 20, 19, 23, and 22.
23 hits.
Okay, for a... After all those arrows get flung your way, you take 2 damage.
Ow.
This is going to be a little different when it gets to Oscar.
Oscar!
You're going to change now. Here, let's see the results. Oh, boy.
What? AC 16, 14, 12, and 24 on their primary
one
attacks.
One hit mysteriously.
3 damage. Oscar basically turns his back, and it's his backpack that gets a bunch of arrows. It pains you. It pains you that some of your stuff is getting hit. And then three of them have secondary attacks for AC 22, 15, and a dirty 20.
2 hits
for 6 damage.
Well. We're getting.
Is he
good
still
thing
up?
We had the medicus happen because we've got 15 hit points left.
Oh, that's amazing. So we're triple moving out of here now. Is that the plan?
Is it time?
No, we're not. I'm the slowest one.
Tommy with his tentacles. Is it time to retreat?
Yes, you asshole.
Okay, Tommy is going to lead the retreat. Down the stairs. Okay, that's one move.
The first time he shows leadership.
And his
it's on the way out.
Third move will be right here so that he can hit things as they come around the corner. It's so dirty in here. Bone Crusher
is going to GTFO. He's going to stay here so he can close the door.
Okay, you've got a ready action to close the door?
Yep, so that was one move. I have 25, 30, so yeah.
Okay.
One move.
Bugbear thugs.
Oscar's weapons. Oh, no. That's right. We'll get it back.
All right, fellas, just fuck off for a while. Jeez. Does anybody have a fireball or something?
We don't have fireballs. Oh, are you serious?
Okay. So those three moved in first. That one had to take a double move, so that flank isn't quite there yet. It's minus fours to do non-lethal damage, right?
I don't know.
It's minus something to do lethal damage with the punch. Give me a second.
Let's
look up. Oh, no, they could just do punches.
So yeah, everybody's proficient in punching.
These three are coming up and are punching with the hilts of their blades, or trying to get the pommels of their sword into Oscar's head.
Get him!
They see that he's woozy. Oh my goodness. AC 13, AC 11, and AC 13. They're trying to grab and punch at Oscar.
It's minus two to do non-lethal with a lethal weapon.
Okay. And then their secondary attacks. They're basically punching and kicking and grabbing.
Stop punching and kicking and grabbing me. My AC's not that good.
AC 18, 16, and 24.
24 is a hit.
So it's a D4, right?
It's a D4 plus strength.
Okay, Oscar's dodging and weaving, and then he.
Which one did that?
It was the last one, so this one.
Okay.
That one. Sorry, the one right beside you.
I'm gonna use my retributive strike on that.
Okay, this is 8 non-lethal.
So 3.
Instead of punching you right in the bridge of your nose, it kind of bounces off your cheek.
So this is. I've got 25 lethal, 3 non-lethal, wounded 1. If I fall down, I'll be 23. Like, I'll be at 0 hit points, wounded 1, and dying 2.
Am I in the bless?
Yes.
Yes, you are. You're right beside the Alcur.
24.
Retributive strike. You end up striking this one bugbear.
For 9 damage.
Okay. And then this one sees that what you're doing, and he double moved to here and is going to take a double-handed swing at Darien.
Okay.
Fucking knights! There are not supposed to be any more knights left!
AC 21. Bang!
Misses.
Okay, your shield blocks the hardy blade from the very strong goblinoid.
Yeah, you do.
This one cowardly bugbear from downtown is going to huck a javelin.
Oh, that's another range increment, maybe?
It is another range increment. Javelins are 30 feet, so I think it's minus 2. This one's going for the knight's head. AC 9.
Yeah, no.
All right. Ald pokes his head around the corner to look at what's going on.
Fuck you!
Wait. Can Shadow see him?
Yeah, through all sorts of meat and cover. Yeah, he's like looking. Are they dead yet?
Oh, I'm fucking...
Or do we have to get Lareth involved?
I suppose I could lure the ghouls.
Don't touch the ghouls. We don't like them.
Yeah, bring ghouls.
Shut the fuck up.
Darien.
Oh. He is going to delay till Oscar can get out of there.
Okay, so Darien's going to delay his initiative from 16 to 11. So that's like your rules.
Darien's a hero, damn it.
It means he'll go after Krieger, actually, because Krieger's in the same pip.
Sure.
Technically, you decide who goes first, but I'm going to...
Fair enough, yeah.
It's hard to do in the spreadsheet. Oscar, what are you doing?
Oscar's going to hike up his little dwarvish skirt, leave his weapons on the battlefield.
Yep.
With much anger. Zoom in on his token. You see those eyes white with hate?
Yeah.
Those are his eyes right now.
Okay.
And we are going to to pump our little dwarvish legs as fast as the little dwarvish legs will pump, which barely gets us out of the
room. Oh, who is that? Oscar? Take the dagger out of my belt. I think it's magical, is what Ptolemy says with his tentacles undulating.
You're fucking right, it's magical.
Krieger.
Krieger's gonna... Yep, time to go. That's one move.
Krieger's long legs putting Oscar to shame, pushing him out of the way.
Whippersnapper!
Oh, we're retreating further.
We're getting the fuck out.
Darien?
Darien is waiting. Oh, Oscar is out. Okay. He'll wait for Al Kerr now.
Okay, so I'm going to delay you until 28 in the initiative, so it's like you rolled a 23 on your initiative. Impossible. Al Kerr.
No one retreats as good as Al Kerr retreats.
You've got a pretty good... pretty good movement rate as an elf, don't you?
I do. And on top of that, I have a travel domain, which means I can ignore difficult terrain and add 5 to my move speed by using a focus point.
Now would be the time.
So, just for funsies. Oops, sorry, that did not do what I wanted to. I'll cur...
With his long, lanky legs also pushes past Oscar through the hole that Krieger made.
He could basically retreat to the first room that we came into. He'll retreat to this door and not use his spell.
Darien?
Okay, Shadows. A warrior. He doesn't need to hide.
We could hide in the prison. Maybe they'll leave us alone.
Actually, he will. You know, that sword over there is magical. Then he leaves.
Why are you telling him?
Oh, you're talking about Oscar's rapier?
Yeah. The one in their midst.
That's funny.
Oh, maybe they'll fight over it.
Give me a charisma check. That's actually pretty smart. Really smart.
Oscar's still upset. Making it even more real.
Diplomacy or
just a charisma check.
Charisma check.
Yeah.
Oh, I should not have used that hero point.
All right.
Yes, I agree. Aw.
It may not have the effect of having the bugbears fight the gnolls, but a couple of the gnolls might spend some actions picking up the blade. Shadow. Darien, did you move all the way?
Well, that was... Did that take an action to hurry?
Nope, that's right. Nope.
No, I got 25 more feet.
Okay, there's no bless running, right?
It's going to be one of those fucking days, isn't it?
Shadow.
It's just time to run.
Can I use a hero point to get an extra move?
No, I don't think so. I think it allows you to re-roll things.
Roll.
Extra roll. Okay, we're gonna rapid shot the man across the... Down, the man downtown.
This guy?
Yep, fuck you. And then we're gonna bug out.
Okay, so his AC is...
I don't wanna know.
Give me a second.
Come on. 30!
You probably hit him. So his AC is...
Here, give me a second. I'm just gonna check to see that you can rapid shot without... declaring him.
His AC is 20 with cover that he took is plus 4 is 24.
So not a crit. I'm just checking to see if the rapid shot requires you to...
Oh, to mark him?
Mark your prey.
It would be a single shot then.
It is... What's the... It's called hunted shot?
Hunter's prey. Hunter's edge.
Yeah, so it's... No, you Hunter's can't. Edge, it's just a single attack unless you're going against your prey.
And I move at
25
feet. Why?
25
Why
feet.
Me?
I would not be able to get out. Oh, no.
Do damage?
Yeah. 1d8. Let's do... 8 damage.
Why?
I'll be back for that. Running the fuck out of there.
Because you're making me stay up past 2 o'clock, you son of a bitch!
And then Crusher is going to close the door and stand behind
and
it.
And then Crusher closes the door. Okay, so I think this is a good place to push pause as you guys are...
That was a bad idea.
Oh, Oscar's so much squishier than everyone else. We had the same AC a couple levels ago. I don't know what happened.
That was so satisfying. After you guys poning, like, the lizards and snakes used their actions to get to you. You killed them. The ogre used his action to get to you. Got a single attack. You killed him. The slimes and the zombies were just a fun romp. Because your paladin was cutting through them like they were paper people. And, yes. This dude that you guys hate is absolutely hilarious.
Oh, the noise.
When he saw things going wrong, everyone sleeping, he's like, I'm gonna go downstairs and use the trap room. That'll show them. Oh.
Well, when he's down there, we're like, not going downstairs. My leg, it's hurt. Come get me. I give up.
Right. Oh, lots of fun. and death. Oh, skirted death a little bit. There are some campaign funsies that will happen even if one of these characters die. So
don't worry, Fox. We're gonna take a nap and then we're gonna pwn the crap out of these guys because it'll be the nap of the ages.
Well, yeah, this is your fourth level right here. Like,
yes,
you probably already got it, but now you're like, let's just keep on tilting because we keep on getting XP as third level characters, not as fourth level characters. So that's actually how you like really tweak the system, unless it says you can't gain enough XP. Like,
what also would have been good, just as a general statement for people who are building characters, you need a high charisma on a cleric. I have, like, a moderate charisma on a cleric. It's not enough.
I think at a coming up level, maybe it's fifth, you get to jack your ability scores.
Yeah.
And then there are apex items that can raise your ability scores as well. So I think that will be fixed over time.
Definitely. The cleric will have an 18 charisma by the time he's done.
I need a name for tonight's game.
What was that asshole's name?
Double back.
Yeah. His name's Ald. Ald's a terrible name. My leg hurts? Or what was he talking about? His leg hurts.
Down my the leg stairs, hurts. Up the stairs.
I hurt my leg.
Attack/retreat.
I hurt my leg. I think is.
I hurt my leg. Yeah, that was a good moment. It's a lot of meat. It's like a dungeon. It's like they stick monsters over here and monsters over here. They can all hear what's going on.
Yeah.
Well, it's the bugbears. 2d12 plus 8 or whatever it is on a crit is a lot of damage.
Yes. Yep.
Bastard swords do d8 plus 4 piercing, but they do two-handed d12s.
Yes. Yes, and then there's one of my questions out there to the universe was who has greatswords anymore?
Yeah.
Oh, because you can just two-hand.
Two-hand a bastard sword, and you can one-hand a bastard sword.
Yeah.
You get slashing with the greatsword. I don't think you get slashing with the bastard sword.
Don't worry, they have a maximum patrol range.
We just have to get outside of it, then we can kite them around their maximum aggro distance.
Right. No, they're coming for you. They see you're weak, and you've shown your weakness, and they want prisoners. Because points to them for sacrifices or prisoners to give to the temple.
Tell me somebody has some explosives.
Awesome. Good place to leave it. I had a lot of fun tonight with this particular the system.
Yeah, it's really engaging. Like the three move, the three actions allow you to dynamically do stuff.
Yeah.
I wonder if we can. Well, Mythic's already kind of doing it.
Yes.
We would have to start from scratch, but I wonder if there's a way to incorporate a three action system into 1E Pathfinder, because I think you could. I think it can. It could be done. I think you could fix 1E Pathfinder some of the rough edges.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, it's almost like
I think the big thing with that, I think, would be adjusting for magic.
Yep.
Magic needs to be adjusted, and then
some feats.
Not to be a little bit harsh, but to unfuck some of the things that Paizo went and fucked.
Alchemist,
we've found many of the combinations.
Swashbucklers, gunslingers, brawler, all of the classes that were not
starting
core.
With Oracle. The Oracle curses. There's Oracle curses that are stupid. It's supposed to be a curse. It shouldn't just be bonuses.
No, it's supposed to be bonuses with a minor curse. At the end of the day, it's a plus.
Yeah. Anyway, so with every splat book, the system became more.
Yes.
You get Scorching Rain, Fireball for having a minus
more variance to the power levels, and then at the end, it's like, why would you ever take a normal fighter? You're gonna take a brawler. You're gonna take a an alchemist. Sort of thing. Yeah.
Yeah, Mark Brawler.
Awesome. No, this is fun. It's not going to replace our legends, but I think for a short period of time we will continue as long as we have momentum and desire to fiddle around with these characters. So, good place to leave it. Thanks for those that joined the stream. It was good to see you folks. We're back to our regular schedule on Saturday, and I hope you guys enjoy this as much as we do. Peace. Have a good night.
Good night, guys. This was awesome.
Yeah. He was 21 years old.
Circle of life.
Yeah, that's good. So, thank you.